Hi, and welcome to IT Chronicles 10 in Tech. I'm Kirstie Magowan. I'm here at Knowledge 17 with my co-host Shane Carlson.
Hello.
And it's our pleasure to be chatting with Sue Desiderio. And Sue's a founding member of the Open Group's IT4IT forum.
Absolutely.
So, man, that's obviously where we're going to start. So, you know, what's happening with IT4IT at the moment? Where's it going? What's the uptake?
Great question. So it's been very exciting, and for those, you know, you may not know too much about it, it's really an open standard on the business of IT. And so it started out really looking at IT value chain, so the end-to-end of what are we delivering as the business of IT to the end customers, be it internal customers or external customers. We have actually ratified two standards now, 2.0, 2.1 is the most recent in December. Uptake has been pretty phenomenal. 15,000, last I knew. I'm sure the numbers are higher than that. But it's resonating with everybody because we're getting down to a layer of tool implementation and how do different systems actually interoperate, which anybody who's been in internal IT for any kind of time knows that that's always been a struggle. So
you find that's exciting people.
It's very exciting.
That's getting them moving.
Yeah. And you also just, you know, you relate to everybody because we've tried to stay tool agnostic, process agnostic, and industry agnostic. I mean, it's all at the business level of IT, and we all talk and we're like, yeah, we all have the same problems, and we all, I mean, it just, everybody
problems haven't changed in the last 20
years,
30, 40 years. They're still the same problems.
Absolutely.
So what would you say to someone who isn't familiar with IT4IT, who may be familiar with IDLE or other ITSM standards and methodologies that are out there? What would you say to them would be the benefit of, you know, looking into IT4IT or even adopting IT4IT's approach in their service management world?
I think what we've said with IT4IT is it's really a layer below IDLE. So IDLE, great framework. I mean, certainly we've used it for several years now, but it never got prescriptive. It never got to that point of, well, how I implement it at my company might be completely different than how someone else implements it. And when you talk down to tools and the vendors and interoperability, every vendor can say they support IDLE V3, which many do today, and yet none of them will talk to each other well. IT4IT gets down to that layer of what are the key functions in the business of IT, what are the key data objects or attributes that need to pass between those functions, and really start specifying at that level in an architecture, if you will, how it works, you know, how it needs to be specified so you can actually pass an incident from one vendor to, you know, a problem of another.
So you would say that the strength is that prescriptiveness, the details that it gets into to kind of create a blueprint for folks who are looking for that level of detail and to guide them through this process. You also mentioned passing incidents between vendors and different tool systems, and that touches a lot on kind of the concept of service integration and management, or SIAM. How do you see IT4IT playing into that SIAM world?
So again, I mean, we know it's a common use case across the board. So what we've done in many cases is take a use case like that, real world issues that people are having, and overlay IT4IT on that and say, okay, have we answered the questions of how we can actually have, you know, three different vendors on incidents and bringing it all into one? And so one of the mechanisms that we use is kind of a scenario-based thing. So we'll get groups of people that are interested in a topic, we'll talk it out, we'll kind of write a white paper, we'll say, hey, does that change anything that's in the standard today? If so, it'll lead kind of to the change process of the standard. And if not, you know, then we know we've vetted it out with another scenario that actually works. But it is evolving. I mean, so we're on version 2.1, we're working on 2.2/3.0, not even sure which version's coming out next, but, you know, it's not all there yet. We know that there's gaps. We're very open of, you know, certain areas are more vetted out than others. But it does give us a starting point. I mean, I think the difference also is that we look at the IT value chain in a whole. So we're looking at all phases, and even with your IDLEs, more in the ops, you know, the typical ops service management space, and we're really looking from the idea and strategy to portfolio through everything to detect to correct. And so there's these value streams that we've kind of put out there for the four value streams, but we look at it holistically. And what's really nice is you can actually have intelligent conversations with the execs at that level one of, yeah, I know that we have ideas and we need to plan for those and we need to develop or outsource that and we need to deliver and we need to keep it running, that resonates. So.
Excuse me.
Oh, no.
So, when it mean you, as you say, tool agnostic, so does it, you know, people change when they want to change tools.
Yes.
It becomes very, very difficult. You can very easily get locked into a tool. So do you think the whole principles of IT4IT are going to make that easier?
As we get through tool certification, yes. So mm-hmm. right now, as far as certification process, mm-hmm. we have people certification with IT4IT. Mm-hmm. We haven't really got to tool certification right. yet. Because it goes back to its
yeah.
evolving, and
yes.
we need to
yep.
really have that mm-hmm. level three, if you yep. talk techie, really defined. But on the roadmap is to get to that point.
So it's definitely on the wish
it's
list.
It's on the roadmap, yes. So we'll get to the point where we can actually start certifying tools in different functions.
Right. Yep.
So now if you have, you know, and the value chain shows what functions interrelate. So at some point, if we have event management, incident yep. management, everybody knows there should be a connection there.
Yes.
When we have those where vendors can be certified, mm-hmm. then they ought to be able to pass those events yeah. and incidents
Absolutely.
Very
yeah.
easily.
Because it can be so difficult to get tools to talk to each other.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it shouldn't be, but
it, shouldn't
it
be,
is.
But
again,
mm-hmm.
it's been what we've been living yeah. and breathing yeah. with yeah. for
There
years.
Are no true standards for that and no vendors
no.
who have signed up to push that along. So any recent and good success stories you can point to for folks that have adopted IT4IT in their environments, maybe coming from a legacy service management idle background?
So I can give you a couple examples. I can't give you names.
That's fine.
But certain companies that I've worked with, again, on the internal IT side, where I've seen the most success in starting out when a company is really looking at kind of how do we kind of adopt the whole thing, underlying to the whole IT value chain is the service model.
Mm-hmm.
And that's really kind of what we focus on, that you want that same service model consistent through all the value streams. So just as an example, I mean, one of the companies, you know, from an operations standpoint, they had a list of applications. And from a project standpoint, they had a list of applications. But they weren't the same list. I mean,
yeah.
and this is just what
mm-hmm.
you see. And everybody has the same problems. So when you go to implement, the first thing that I've done on several implementations is you start with that service model. What is the architecture, which IT4IT gives some guidelines? And how do we get standardized so it doesn't matter what part of the organization you're with, you know, be it security, projects,
yeah.
ops, you're all working with that same model, and you kind of go from there.
That makes mm-hmm. sense.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much for joining us today, Sue.
No problem.
We really appreciate it. It's actually
yeah.
a very good talk. So
excellent.
Thank you
very much.
Thanks, Sue.
Thank you.